In our last video, we talked about what makes the Cloud Talent Solution Job Search API a good fit for improving the quality of job searching. Now, let's look at the best ways to implement the API into your job search solution and go over planning details to get started. One important thing to note about the Job Search API is that it's a search index of your jobs. This means it's intended to work alongside your existing database by mirroring the contents and searching against it in a manner that's optimized to find the most relevant results to a search query. This means it acts something like a middle layer for the underlying system. In order for the API to best determine relevant search results, it stores information that you provide about the jobs and uses a pre-trained machine learning model with your provided data to return relevant results. Once the API is integrated into your system, your users will see high-quality search results immediately. For many businesses, this improvement in search quality is more than sufficient. If you want to further refine the ordering, the API also offers configuration options, as well as the ability to further train the model. We'll talk about these in depth in later videos. You'll want to make sure that you keep your job database as the primary source of truth and use the Job Search API as a search index. With that in mind, let's take a look at how to plan out an implementation so you can connect your job solution to the Job Search API. To get the data into the API, you'll connect it to your database, but not to your front end quite yet. Using the Google Client Library, which is available in a number of languages, you can access the Job Search API directly, or you can implement a custom connector through the REST or RPC interface. Once connected, you can start by sending a list of jobs and companies to the API, which then analyzes and indexes them into a searchable form. When uploading the data to the API, it's important to consider your capacity needs. Capacity planning makes sure the API can provide the appropriate support for all of the daily operations, such as adding and deleting jobs and companies. Here are some factors to consider when looking at capacity. How frequently are jobs created, updated, and deleted? How often do job seekers receive alerts? For both of these, you'll need to estimate the capacity for batch data loads as well as normal daily usage. How frequently are job seekers doing searches? Capacity here should be measured for peak and daily usage. With capacity planning set up, you're in good shape to start uploading data. Once your data is uploaded, the Job Search API will be ready to use thanks to the built-in ML models. When designing your integration, it's important to ensure that your solution is built in a fault-tolerant manner. That way, if the Job Search API index needs to be tweaked for any reason, you can route traffic back to your existing backend without interrupting your user's job search experience. We'll go through and share more information and tips to help you plan your implementation. Stay tuned for our next video, where we'll dive a little deeper and look at configuring search results from the API. Thanks for watching, and remember, when looking for talent, it's okay to keep your head in the cloud.